everyone. This is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about Handbrake. I want to focus in on the sound settings for Handbrake because I want to share a little bit of an experience that I had. So we're ready to drop the file in here for compressing. And you can click on the link above for the video that I had for optimal settings on Handbrake. We can go through those quickly here. Normally I select this as web optimized. Don't do anything with dimensions. Filters I leave alone. The video I usually set same as source. Constant frame rate. Make this very slow. And I have played around with this quality setting, although I think 22 is probably okay. It doesn't really need to be changed. On the audio, what I found out is sometimes when it was processing a file, it would cause distortion with the MP3 portion of the file. So by changing that and making it on the video pass-through, when you save, let's save the file, start the encode. The difference in the file size is extremely small. So passing through the audio increases the file size by a minuscule amount. And I recommend just using pass-through all the time because it's not going to change the size of your video files. Okay, so you can see it's finished. And the size of that file went from 409,000 kilobytes to 37,000 kilobytes. Oh, okay. I'm recording, Mahalko. Oh, okay. So let's put it back to the AAC.
Sorry.
Tell me when you're done.
All
right, you okay now?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, so now that that's completed, let's put it back to the AAC encoding for the sound, and we'll put this, give it a different name. We'll start the encode, and we'll just compare the two file sizes. Okay, so that's done. Let's compare the two files. Now you can see the one that had the pass-through is 37,000 kilobytes. The one that had the encoding with the sound is 27,000 kilobytes. So you save 10,000 kilobytes, but you take a chance on distorting the file. So let's just see if we can tell a difference in the sound. Okay, so they sound similar. I was getting some distortion on, in particular, S sounds. It's probably the way I enunciate, but the S, sometimes it was a little shrill on the compression, and since I've done the pass-through, I have no more problems with the distortion. So if you're having problems with distortion, you may want to turn it off and do the pass-through. This concludes our video demonstration of using Handbrake to pass through the audio compression. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great and wonderful automation day.